This report makes for very disturbing reading, and I have no doubt very distressing reading for the family. My thoughts are with them at this time. It's very clear that there was a failure of basic care, and I think out of a 250-page plus report, there is one page that has a graph in it that shows over the first 4 days of the late Savita Halappanavar's care, there were 13 different points where actions could have been taken that might have changed the very tragic outcome. I want to say I haven't had the report for very long, but my immediate response is that patient safety has to be seen as paramount in our service. As such, the next National Service Plan will have a very strong emphasis on patient safety. It will be an integral part of it. The other thing I'd like to say is that I think in the past there may have been an attitude amongst management that patient safety is an issue for clinicians alone. It is not and cannot be the case. So each CEO of each hospital and each new hospital group will have it made very clear to them that this is a core part of their responsibility and has to be their primary concern, and that they'll be expected to ensure the safety of the patients that attend their hospital, obviously supported by their clinical directors. They certainly will make sure to implement the recommendations in this report, and further I'll be directing the chairman of HIQA that patient safety priorities of mine will be reflected in the monitoring reports that HIQA present to me. We do need to develop a full national maternity service plan, and we will do that with urgency. I have already mandated the national early warning scorecard and a national maternity early warning scorecard. We will now develop a similar mechanism for the recognition of sepsis and for clinical handovers, which are a time clearly identified of risk that where information may be lost or not passed on in a sufficiently clear fashion. So again, I'd like to express my sympathy to the family, and I'd like to say that I deeply regret that our health service failed in such a catastrophic way to deal with the care of Savita Halappanavar.
During the Protection of Life During Pregnancy Bill, we heard a lot that Ireland is one of the safest places to have a baby. Now, that's impossible to tell according to the HIQA report because that data isn't being collected. Are you going to ensure that that report on every maternity hospital nationally is now carried out?
Absolutely. But I mean, all the statistics we do have show that we are one of the safest places in the world for childbirth. But clearly an incident like this is one that demonstrates where human failure has such a catastrophic effect, and not just by one person but by several people involved in the care of the patient. What deeply disturbs me is the fact that we had a similar case a number of years ago where a young woman, Tanya McCabe, lost her life in her twins. That lesson certainly was learnt in that hospital, but it has been a recurring theme of mine about the HSE's failure to transpose excellence across the system, that when lessons are learned in one place, that they're not learned right across the system. When people are doing things well in one place, that's not transposed across the system. The new hospital groups will go a long way to help address this, because we will have the 6 groups plus the paediatric hospital group, which means 7 managers, you know, to talk to give the message to deliver it out throughout our hospital system, as opposed to 49 as we have at the moment.
Minister, how long do you think it will take every hospital to learn that lesson?
Well, we're going to put in place the recommendations. I'm going to make sure that the implementation is monitored, and I want it done as soon as possible. And I would expect that with the hospital groups, we'd be able to expedite it so that definitely within the next 12 months, these systems will be in place, and that all staff will understand their duty of care to the patient, the protocols that have to be followed, and most importantly, that management understands its role as well in protecting patients.
Minister, Pravin Halappanavar has been seeking a meeting with you since the inquest returned a verdict to death by medical misadventure on the 13th, I think, of April. Are you going to meet him? Are you going to apologise to him and Savita's family?
I would be very happy to meet Pravin Halappanavar. I've met him twice. for one reason or another, our paths didn't cross, it didn't suit. But I am certainly available and will be more than happy to meet with him. And as I say, I deeply regret that our health service has failed his wife in such a terrible way.
Could I also ask, you referred the HSE report to the Medical Council and on board alternate. Is there going to be any fitness to practice inquiries as a result of that?
Well, that's a matter for the Medical Council, obviously. That's their remit, and I would be most inappropriate for me to interfere as a minister. I've heard nothing back. Indeed, there's a recommendation in this report that the management of Galway should consider referring a complaint themselves, and I will obviously leave that to them to consider. But I want to reiterate again, this has been such a catastrophic failure in the care of a patient that we've got to make sure that the lessons learned are learned by everybody and not just the people in Galway.
Minister, a lot of the opponents of your protection life during pregnancy legislation were saying that the Savita case was separate and it was human error really in the system was the cause. You know, what's your view after looking at the HIQA report?
Well, very clearly, human error was a major part of what happened here. I always maintained that we were going ahead with our review and our expert group and legislation in any event, and it was terribly tragic that what happened in Galway happened. But the necessity for us to bring in the Protection of Life and Pregnancy Bill was there before this, and I'm very proud and pleased that we got that through the Dáil and that the people, I believe, wanted that.
Can I ask you, sir, on a separate issue, the budget is going due next week. A lot of suggestions in your department is the one that is stalling the final deal on savings for ahead next year. What do you have to say in that?
Well, there's lots of suggestions about lots of things. But the reality is that nothing is settled till everything is settled, and there's a number of departments that haven't settled yet. And I'm looking forward to further meetings with Brendan Howland, and we all want the same thing. I want to be able to run a service that's safe, and I want us out of the bailout, and so does he and so does this government. So we're going to get out of the bailout, and health will do what it can on its part to help do that. But I have to have patient safety to the fore, and I don't in any way mean to take from this report or anything like that, but I mean that has to be my primary concern. We don't want to have to preside over other tragedies in our service because of patient safety issues.
Is
and I certainly won't.
Protecting the budget drug payment scheme, anything at all that people can be reassured about?
Well, I'm not going to conduct the budget negotiations here, if you don't mind.
There we go. Thank you very much indeed. Okay.